Oh my goodness. No, this is not a joke. I'm Mark Baxter and I feel awful. My head is pounding, my eyes are watering, my nose is running, my body's aching, I've got a little fever, my glands are swollen, my throat kills me, and the only real question I have is, should I cancel my gig tonight? Isn't that always the way? You're working towards a special gig or audition, rehearsing your butt off, and then about 3 days before you feel just a little twinge and you know something is brewing. And not until the morning of do you get that wallop. Excuse me. And I'm sure you've been in this situation before. So I figured, what better time to do a podcast about that age-old question, to sing or not to sing when you have a cold? So let's get started. Now, please keep in mind, I've got a lifetime of experience behind me. And so what I'm going to do is sort of unfold my process as my morning goes on, and you can make your own decisions based on hopefully some information you learn from this podcast. What's excuse me. What's important is to leave yourself a lot of wiggle room, and that's why it's morning right now. Right now it's 7:43 a.m. and I got up early because I knew last night that my voice was going to get ravaged. And it's kind of counterintuitive. You'd think you should sleep in, but you've got this nagging question on your mind. Should I cancel? And venues and bandmates are not very fond of canceling last minute. It's not a good reputation to have. And you don't want to force yourself to sing should your situation be unsolvable. So it's very important to start to make an assessment early in the day. And believe me, I'm going to go back to sleep in a little while. I just got to get a read on my voice. And that's my first point to you. Get an early assessment, and then through experience, you can make valid judgments later. And that is, as the day goes on, I'm going to check in as I'm warming up and feeling out my voice. But by around noon or 1 o'clock p.m., I'm going to want to make a decision so that I can notify everybody concerned, and hopefully the decision is I can sing. But if you can't sing, you don't want to force anything. You just got to let people know early. Now, obviously, I'm not a doctor. I'm a singer. And I'm doing this as a service. I'm taking a bullet for you guys. I'm doing this as a service so you can feel it out. Every cold, every situation is different. And of course, every person is different. So this is not written in stone. There's always questions. And the first question I have for myself is, can I get rid of the cough? Can I minimize the cough? The coughing and clearing is very irritating to the folds. And you can obviously hear that my voice is much lower than it usually is. And it sounds husky. It sounds irritating. I've got this nagging drip, a post-nasal drip, and I've got a tickle in the back of my throat. So I already know mid-song, mid-phrase, this is going to nag at me. So I've got to get that handled first. One of the things I like to do is gargle with warm salt water. And that helps to bring up any mucus or congestion that's sort of lolling around in the area. And I'm going to shoot back an eyedropper full of echinacea and golden seal root combo. It's an herbal extract. Tastes nasty. I keep it in the refrigerator to take some of the bitterness away from it. But I finally refer to it as dumpster juice, as it's awful. But I'm going to go do that. I'm going to go gargle and shoot down some herbal extract and see if I can't clear out a little bit. And this is what I'm going to do during this podcast. I'm going to go away and come back and go away and come back. So give me a minute and I'll be right back with whatever result I get after gargling and golden seal root. All right, it's now 8 a.m. and my throat feels a little better. I've gargled a few times. And let the echinacea do its thing. This is when a normal person would have a cup of tea, something nice, and I'm just not a normal person. I don't care for tea. And just keep in mind that anything we drink or swallow, the gargle, none of this is touching the vocal folds. And as you can hear, my voice is a little bit clearer, but my pitch is still fairly low, and that indicates that my vocal folds are swollen, and that's no surprise. So as the day goes on, that's going to be my task, is to get the swelling down in my folds, get the tickles away, make sure that I don't have any triggers that should surprise me or re-irritate the situation. So now I'm going to go through a bunch of vocal exercises and tests, if you will, as the day goes on, and see if I can't elevate the pitch of my voice naturally, not something I'm going to force it to do. And as the morning ensues, I'm going to be making more and more assessments as to whether I should sing tonight. Important to remember not to force your voice to sing any particular pitch when you begin your vocal day, your warm-up, your vocalizing. And that's whether you're healthy or sick. I always let my voice decide what note I start with. And that's just whatever feels the most comfortable. Obviously, this morning, that feels like I don't need any effort whatsoever to produce that sound. Right there, feels like it's going to close up on me. I'm stopping the tickle right at that point. I can go lower. Perhaps I should sing some Barry White today. I can go lower because my folds are fat, and that's the problem. They're swollen and fat. So I'm going to take that hum, and I don't like that double tone right there. So I'm exploring, and you should too. And keep in mind, this is, again, the experience that I have of keeping my neck loose, not adding more air pressure, muscle independence. Can't express how valuable that is when assessing something as important as, should I load this up later on tonight? And so I'm going to continue to hum and search around for some comfortable notes. Now, even though that had an awful sound to it, it felt okay to produce that. And I'm just going to gradually ask for higher pitches. I'm not forcing. Now, up in that upper register there, that feels okay to produce that sound, but it obviously is very fragile. Now, hopefully you've listened to previous podcasts, especially about range and power, and you know that my approach to range and power is you go soft first. You go pianissimo, as unloaded, as easy and weightless and free, always important. So I'm going to check those high notes, and I can sing that. That's working, but I know the bridge is going to have a big old gap there. So there's nothing I can sing right now. But again, this is vocalizing. I'm just testing the waters. So I'm going to slide down from there. Just a fifth's worth of pitch. And meanwhile, I haven't gone to a piano yet. I haven't checked where I am. That doesn't matter. What matters is that I have some area, a distance, a few different pitches that I can connect together as an indicator that things may open up for me as the day ensues. When you hear all that fry, I'm not going to rush to fix that. Very gentle. Eee. Eee. one had a kind of a hard onset. That's the onset right there. So I'm going to be cautious and back off that. Little mini H will do the trick. A little he. Little air aspirated first. Now it's still early, so I'm not going to force this. And one more. It's kind of a sticky beginning. So let me find. Okay, so I'm right there, G flat, F sharp. So my point is, I went and I sang first and found the pitch second. And that keeps me from forcing. If I know I can sing an A or G or whatever, I'm going to be more likely to force my voice, and it's going to give me a false read, a false assessment. I can probably force those notes out and produce a pitch. That's not my agenda. My agenda is that I want those notes for free, light and easy, later on today, so I can make an assessment about the gig. All right, I'm going to take a break here, and I'm going to come back probably in an hour. So I feel pretty good about my chances of singing. And what I want to do is sort of start my day, and I'm going to come back, and that's when I'll continue this podcast. All right, it's 9 a.m. now, and I've had my breakfast, and I did some floor stretches, some body stretches, and I'm feeling better. And I've been walking around my house doing these little noises. Gee, 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 gee. So I wanted to come back here and fill you in on the action. And so the reason I'm in the upper register is that requires your folds be thin. The physiology of registers is simply that the upper register, or commonly called head register, is thinner in its mass than the chest register or lower register. There's a muscle inside that provides that. The thyroid arytenoid muscle is what thickens and thins the vocal folds. And so the point is, when they're swollen, they're going to be thick without that muscle and therefore produce a much lower sound, like bass strings on a guitar. Anyway, so I'm asking for these high, thin, low volume, very lightweight sounds, key, 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 in order to, again, assess how easy is it for me to ask my folds to thin down. It also helps promote that activity. So let's see where I am. I'm here at G. Key, 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 key. Key, 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 key. And this is, of course, for guys. Ladies, you'd be up here. Easy, no pushing, no shoving. Key, 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 key. Forgive any little pitch issue. Key, 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 key. And here. Key, 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 key. So I'm starting my day, I'm starting to get specific with pitch, but I've already been goofing around for an hour or a little hour and a half about. And so just now I'm starting to ask for more specific pitches. And again, I'm going to be loose with that. Key, 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 key. And that question is that low note there. How am I going to transfer? How am I going to change from one register to another? Will it be smoother or rough shot? Key, 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 key. Key, 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 key. Key, 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 key. So I'm starting to ask for a transition. Key, 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 key. Keeping the notes short. Key, 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 key. 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 Any little flubs are forgivable. Key, 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 key. Still low volume. Key, key, ki, ki, ki. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. In here. Ki, 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 ki. So I'm going to do this over and over intermittently throughout the next hour or so. I'm going to check in with my voice and see if this exercise doesn't get easier to access the crossover between registers. And then I'll come back to the podcast and hopefully we can demand a little more musicality out of my voice. All right, now it's a little after 11 a.m. and my voice has taken a little backslide. And that's because I went back to bed. Now there's a two-step forward, one-step back logic here. And that is that I'm assessing my voice. I want to know early enough in the day, but I'm going to be singing later at night. There's a small window of opportunity that I need to create for the set that I'm going to sing to have the best voice possible so I could present that. And that means I need rest, I need food, I need vocalizing. And so the rest is a big part of this. And each time you rest, every time you sleep, because you're horizontal and because my body is fighting an infection, I'm going to be a little worse for wear each time I get back up. But each step I move forward, that means I won't be as bad off as I was before. Okay, so let's see what's going on. I'm gonna try and connect and do the example of what I mean by backslide. Ki, 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 ki. That's okay. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. That's very finicky. Ki, 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 ki. Just won't stay put there. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. And I'm not forcing. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. So again, not being very specific with pitch, but I'm just looking for that little patch between registers, the passaggio. And that's going to be my Achilles heel because I've got a cold. And it's usually an Achilles heel because people don't have the skill yet to go through there. So I know I can, so that's what I'm using as my gauge. Until I can get through that passaggio seamlessly, I'm not going to load up my voice, ask for any more volume or any more musicality from it. So I'm going to continue to do this exercise. Ki, 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 that little scale, sporadically throughout the next hour, until I can patch over or bridge over the change of register. I'll check back in later. All right, now it's approaching noon, and my voice is slowly coming around. I wanted to let you know that I've changed the vowel from an E to a deep oo sound. Coo, 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 coo. I've got a little patch happening between in that passaggio area. The deep oo gives me a semi-occluded advantage. What that means is that I'm closing off my lips, making a teeny little hole with the, just the embouchure there. And what that does is hold back some air pressure, so it creates a downforce on top of the vocal folds. And that helps to create a little neutral area for them. The top of the fold closes at the same time the bottom of the fold does, giving me a much better closure. So that coo, 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 I've got less erratic tones happening there. Coo, 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 coo. Bridging over. Coo, 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 coo. Coo, 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 coo. Now, I started with the E vowel earlier because I wanted a reality check. And as I got closer to noon, I got a little nervous, wondering if I'd be able to do this tonight. So that's when I went to the toolkit and used the deep oo sound to give me a little advantage there as I vocalize. I'm going to stick with this for another hour. Remember, 1 o'clock is around when I want to make my determination, so I'll check back in later. Now it's coming up on 1 o'clock, and I've been changing back and forth between oo and e. Let's give it a check. Gee, 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 gee. 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 Now it's time to skate in the other direction. Gee, 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 gee. To see how the voice behaves. Gee, 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 gee. Still a little rough. Gee, 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 gee. Gee, 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 gee. Gee, 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 gee. I'm going to work on this for a couple minutes, and then I'm going to move on to an ah. All right, I've switched over to ah, and I don't like what I'm hearing. The reason I'm waiting before I go into ah is that it is the most exposed sound I can make. It's easy to get into compensation when singing when sick. And that compensation is what leads to the re-irritation or the further irritation to the voice. It's what gives singing when sick a bad reputation. If we don't push, if you don't add any extra behaviors, it's therapeutic in a way to vocalize very softly when sick. All the little hee-hee-hee that I did at the beginning helped me reduce that trigger-happy cough. Those unproductive coughs are irritating to the folds, and therefore, any way you can non-narcotically reduce your cough is good. But now as I'm going up to an ah, I'm starting to hear a little too much fatigue still in my voice. Ga, 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 ga. Ga, 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 ga. Hear all those extra tones in the sound? Ga, 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 ga. Ga, 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 ga. And here. Ga, 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 ga. Now I can cover or sort of scoot around that. Ga, 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 ga. See, if I push, I can sound better, but that's going to give me a very short shelf life to my voice. If you can't produce the clear sound you need at a low volume, then you got no business producing it at a loud volume. It's just a camouflage. And so I'm going to have to work on this a little bit more. I'm going to extend my deadline. And until I hear a clear ah, I'm not going to give the green light for singing tonight. Now, just after about 10 minutes or so of working with ah, that's starting to come around. Ga, 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 ga. Got a little clearer tone there, more encouraging. Ga, 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 ga. 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 Now, at this point, I'm starting to lean towards singing tonight because my speech, as you can hear, is feeling less burdened, and the ahs are starting to clear up. So at this point, I'm going to test out a little bit of singing. Oh, 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 oh. See how it behaves for me. Oh, oh, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. All right, so at this point, I'm gonna not make the phone call to cancel. And this is because I know my voice very well. And that's the biggest point I can leave with you in this podcast. Know your voice. If you're a professional singer, you've got to make assessments like this a lot. And you, no gig is worth harming your voice, but to be a professional means you're gonna do more gigs than you cancel, that's for sure. And so I didn't panic when I woke up this morning. I know this routine very well. It's now just coming up to, let's see, it's 1:30, so it would be a little after my deadline, but since I'm not calling anyone to cancel, I'm good to go. No one will realize it. I'm not going to tell anyone that I was iffy about the show because I don't want anyone listening to my voice with doubt. And this is, to me, the hardest part is not telling anyone what you went through to do the gig. Don't taint their perception of you. And so what did we learn? We learned stop from the start your voice from a pitch that your voice selects, not the piano. And we learned that it's best to work from top down. So whatever you can get comfortably in head register, and you want to bring that stuff down, it's okay to sound bad, not okay to feel bad. And most importantly, we learned that I don't like tea. So keep this stuff in mind as you sing. Really important to explore this stuff without a gig pressing on you. So the next time you're sick, play this game. What if? What if you had a show tonight? And work through the timetable as I have. I started very early this morning, and let's say it's, you know, at 2 o'clock, I will, or 3 o'clock, I'll probably take another nap. And that's going to set me back a step, but I don't worry because I'll go through this whole routine all over again. And then I'll do the same thing again around 5 or 6 before heading out to the venue. So at that point, when I get to the venue, I'll do my normal warm-up routine. And I'll be very cautious through the gig. And I'll live to sing another day. So remember, sing with the voice you have, not the one you wished you had. I'm Mark Baxter for Voice Counsel.com.